Wait a minute, so the Big Bang, did it happen? To everyone who sees them, the new James Webb Space Telescope images of the cosmos are beautifully awe-inspiring. But to most professional astronomers and cosmologists, they are extremely surprising. Not at all what was predicted by theory. In the flood of technical astronomical papers published online since July 12, the authors report again and again that the images show surprisingly many galaxies. Galaxies that are smooth, galaxies that are small, surprisingly old. There's a lot of surprises and not necessarily pleasant ones. One paper's title begins with the candid exclamation, "Panic! Why do the James Webb Space Telescope images inspire panic among cosmologists? And what are theories' prediction that they are contradicting?" The papers don't actually say these things. The truth that these papers don't report is that the hypothesis that the James Webb images are blatantly and repeatedly contradicting is the Big Bang hypothesis, that the universe began 14 billion years ago in an incredibly hot, dense state and has been expanding ever since. Since that hypothesis has been defended for decades as unquestionable truth by the vast majority of cosmological theorists, the new data is causing these theorists to panic. Although we didn't usually hear of it, there's been dissatisfaction with the standard model, which begins with the Big Bang. Ever since it was proposed by George Lemaître nearly a century ago, but no one expected the James Webb to contribute to that debate. The Big Bang theory crucially depends on inflation. The hypothesis that at the outset of the universe expanded many orders of magnitude faster than the speed of light. But experiments have failed to prove evidence of cosmic inflation, and since the theory's inception, it has been beset by deep puzzles. Now, one of its founders, Paul Sainhart, has denounced the theory as mistaken and scientifically meaningless. But do we have to give up the theory of cosmic inflation and seek a radical alternative? Might alternative theories like the Big Bounce or abandoning the speed of light provide a solution? Or are such alternatives merely sticking plasters to avoid the more radical conclusion that it is time to give up on the Big Bang altogether, maybe? I mean, to be honest, the current thinking is that the Big Bang nucleosynthesis era produced 75% of hydrogen and 25% of helium by weight, and a smattering of lithium, but not much else. Then, after 300,000 years, the universe cooled down enough to produce atoms, and gravitational attraction slowly, slowly built up stars. Early ones were big enough to explode, and the shockwave sent through the hydrogen gas caused pockets to form that began star making in earnest. But it still took 500 million years to get enough stars for a galaxy. Now, the earlier a galaxy forms, the further back in time and the further away it is from astronomers today. And the further away it is, the faster it is moving away from us. This movement causes the light to be redshifted. So robust is this relationship that astronomers replace time with redshift, but the Hubble Space Telescope could only see visible light, and those early galaxies were so redshifted they were only visible in the infrared, which is where the James Webb Telescope really shines. So one of the goals of the James Webb Telescope essentially was to see the earliest galaxies, and indeed, it's seeing a lot. What does this mean for the standard model? Theorists have an answer. Lots of clumpy dark matter to get the hydrogen gas to clump early, basically. This leads to the question, why isn't the dark matter clumpy now? I don't have endurance to run down every rabbit trail cosmologists propose, but instead I propose that the first stars were not made of hydrogen, they were actually made of ice. The Big Bang synthesized abundant C and O, which combined with H to form H2O, CO2, and CH4, etc. These gases freeze relatively early in the universe timeframe, so clumping was not gravitational, but physiochemical, the same way snowflakes basically form. So we didn't have to wait 500 million years for snowflakes to clump, it just happened very quickly once the universe cooled below the freezing point. Hence though, James Webb sees lots of redshifted galaxies from the early universe, and this explains a lot. This sometimes comes up actually. Could the universe have always existed? The Problem is, if the universe had existed for an infinite amount of time, everything that could possibly happen must already have happened an infinite number of times, including that we don't exist and really never did, but we do exist, and at least we know we do, and Robert J. Marx has pointed out playing with infinity quickly results in absurdity. To do science, we must accept that some events are real and not mutually contradictory. So we can assume that the universe got started, but are a little less sure just now how that happened. So that's pretty much it. What I believe is pretty much how the James Webb might not really be proving the Big Bang Theory. It might be also against it. I put on all the references in the description, so make sure to check that out. Otherwise, thanks for watching this channel. We have a couple cool videos about Webb's latest imagery and also some analysis on them, so make sure to check that out. If you want to know, for example, the analysis of the Triangulum Galaxy, then watch this video right here. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video, and cheers.